What's up, guys, and welcome back to another Duelist deck presentation. Today we are playing another Cyric deck, but this time more with a focus on the mid-range. We have some spells here. We are dropping the Science Second Wish and the Primus Shieldmaster for now, looking for some more minions. That's the Altars and the Scarab. Going against the Songhai, it's Reaver Eventide. A Bloodbond spell is that she can summon a Heartseeker, that's a ranged minion, nearby the general. So let's play the Primus Fist and we are buffing it to draw another card. Getting a Primus Shieldmaster. And another the Altars. Summoning a Bastion at the end of his turn and other friendly minions are gaining plus one health. Dropping at the Altars here and might be best to silence him now. Otherwise he will, for example, play the Heartseeker next turn that will get buffed and other minions as well. He has a full hand at the moment, so we are dispelling it. He's giving the general plus 5 attack, killing the Primus Fist. And with his 3 mana he's summoning a Lantern Fox. Let's put out a Scarab here. Should be able to deal with most of his minions next turn. I wanted the Bloodbond spell of the Cyrix is that he can summon a 2/2 Iron Dervish nearby a random place. A Lightbender. Ooh, that was wasteful. He's silencing both our minions. See, we are killing the Heartseeker. Also need to kill the Lantern Fox. Dropping a Primus Shieldmaster here. The Altars will attack the general. We are also summoning an Iron Dervish. Bone Reaper. That one will deal 2 damage to all nearby enemy minions at the end of his turn. So the Primus Shieldmaster will die, but the Starfire Scarab will survive. And let's see, the Provoke minion is a problem here. Place it in the Altars, hopefully. No, that's not bad. So we will kill it. How much is it? He has 14 at the moment, that's 9, 11, and that's enough to finish him. So, first victory. And let's finish the game here. The second match is against Magma. And we are finally in the gold division. Was a bit slow this month, but we did it. So against the Magma, starting hand is quite good. We don't need to replace anything. Magma is one of the weakest classes at the moment. So no need to be afraid of it. We will drop the tiger here and kill the phalanx right away. Playing a bloodshot golem. We will again kill it with a tiger and hit the general for two. Oh, that's bad at the moment, the Earthwalker. We can't deal with it. We can play the Repulsor Beast and push it back. But I guess we will replace a card. Yeah, that's better. Let's drop the Obelisk at the top. Play the Repulsor Beast. And push it to the back. We can dispel it later on. There's no need right now. With the remaining mana, we will summon an Iron Dervish. So the Obelisk here is safe for the moment. And we can summon some Wind Dervish each turn. No, we can't. He's killing it. Let's replace one of the Primus Fists. The DK might be good later on. We will dispelling the Earthwalker now. Take the General. And also play the Healing Mystique. And heal back to 18. We are placing it here so it is out of reach for the Earthwalker. Otherwise, he can kill it. Killing the Mystique, can't counterattack, and playing a Brightmoor Golem. That one will die to the DK. Now let's kill it. We are summoning another Dervish and also buffing it with a Doomcaster. Earthwalker is now a 5-5. So, enough to kill the dervish. That means he will also kill the Dunecaster with the general. No, he's buffing it. And also playing another strong minion. It's pretty bad here. Pretty bad. Seal back to 12 and also playing the Scarab. Sadly, it won't survive the turn. And kill the Mystique with the Earthwalker and then attack with his general, so we would be down to 4 or 3 if he is using the Bloodborne spell. No, he's pushing it, killing the Scarab and still attacking, so we are down to 3. He is at 9. It's crap, we can't even play the Primus on the healing Mystique. Oh, we can, of course. So let's buff him and get rid of the artifact. He's at 5-5. So if we can kill the Primus Fist, would have attacked us, but that's not the case. We might be able to snatch the win here if we play the Dunecaster onto the Iron Dervish. He only has, yeah, that's enough. Ooh, that was a close one. So far so good, and we are finished for today's deck video. I'm currently running a giveaway to celebrate 1500 subscribers. You can win a Steam copy of Hurtworld or Lifeless, so please enter the competition if you don't already have done it, and check out the video on the right. If you have enjoyed the video and don't want to miss future content, just subscribe to the channel for free. Thanks a lot for watching. Until then, guys, cheers!